Hi all, electrical engineer, Igor Ekimov, is with you. How to strip the insulation from a wire as quickly as possible. Automatic strippers are better suited for this. Today we will look at universal stripper pliers from the company, GVDA, whose devices I am reviewing not for the first time. They work as an automatic wire stripper, wire cutter, automotive terminal crimper, and non-contact NCV live wire indicator. They are sold in two versions, as individual pliers, like mine, and with a set of tips and ties. The link to the pliers is in the description. If you are interested in tools and devices for electrical installation, then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. Here the ticks remove the insulation. There are wire cutters here. Here you can crimp the lugs for the car wiring. And here is the non-contact live wiring indicator NCV. This tool is similar to insulation strippers from other companies, but its jaws are made entirely of alloy steel, which will allow this tool to work for a long time. This screw adjusts the force with which the insulation is held when stripping. I tightened it enough that I could strip most of the wires. But if you don't have enough effort to remove the insulation, or, on the contrary, the conductor is damaged, then this screw needs to be adjusted. In this case, the adjustment does not depend on what cross-section of wire you have, and it depends more on the thickness and rigidity of the insulation. There is a wire stop so you can strip the wire to a certain length. This stop can be removed if it bothers you. Personally, I usually don't use this emphasis. This stripper is great for household needs and for car repairs. But if you are going to do professional electrical installation, then I recommend getting a more substantial stripper. I will review one such stripper later. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss it. Let's see how the tool works in practice. Its main function is as an insulation stripper. It strips wires with soft insulation easily. For example, let's take the ShVVP wire. We lay the wire and squeeze the handles. And, as you can see, the wire is stripped. He removed the outer insulation. Now we clamp both wires at once and strip the insulation from two wires at once. A few seconds and the wire is completely stripped. Single-stranded wires are also easy to strip. Here, for example, is a PV3 wire with a cross-section of 6mm too. Let's take a bite of it. We clamp the wire, squeeze the handles, and our wire is stripped. As you can see, the vanes are not damaged. Let's try to strip the PVS wire. Here we lay the wire, squeeze the handles. As you can see, the outer insulation came off easily. We're filming. We can also strip both wires at once. The insulation and conductors of the wire are not damaged. Anyone who has tried to strip a PVA wire with a knife knows that this is not an easy task. What about cables that are used in electrical installations? For example, VVGng. Here I have a 3*1.5mm two cable. Clean it up. So I removed the outer insulation. We clamp three wires at once. So I removed the insulation from three wires at once. As you can see, both the insulation and the conductors are not damaged. But the cable is 3*2.5mm too. Let's cut it off. So I cut it off. Let's try to clean it up. As you can see, the outer insulation is difficult to clean. So I cleaned it up. Let's try to remove the insulation from three cores at the same time. It is also difficult to remove the insulation from three cores. That is, working with this stripper with a 3*2.5 VVGng cable is already becoming difficult. It removes the outer insulation well from some cables, but not the first time from others. That is, if you are installing a cable on site, it is better to check how the cable is stripped directly on the market before purchasing. And this applies not only to this stripper, but also to other strippers that you use. During my practice, I have seen many different wires and cables. Both the rigidity and thickness of the insulation are different. You may be offered cables on the market with very rigid insulation, or when the insulation of the wires is literally glued to the outer insulation, as in this cable. Then not only with an automatic insulation stripper, but it is problematic to clean such a cable with a knife. If you encountered such difficulties when working with an automatic stripper, then write about it in the comments and how you overcame this problem. I plan to review this professional automatic stripper in a while. If this household stripper has difficulty stripping a 3*2.5 cable, then this one can strip the insulation from a 3*6 cable. True, it costs 1.5 to 2 times more, but it will more than pay for itself when used in professional electrical installation. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss a video. It's convenient that there are wire cutters here. As you have seen, they bite wires well. I took a bite, cleaned it, and connected the wire. And here is the place where the tool crimps the lugs for the car wiring. These pliers cope well with the process of crimping tips. But for automotive tips, I recommend using professional pliers. This tool can be used to check the presence of voltage in the panel. To do this, turn the insulation stripper over. We take out the film from here that was installed by the manufacturer. And we check the operation of the sensor. To do this, click on the red button. We heard two beeps and the LED lit up twice. This indicates that the sensor is ready for use. And to check the presence of voltage, press the red button. As you can see, it shows the presence of a field. The closer we get, the more often the LED lights up and the signal sounds. We carry it, the signal disappears. Turn it off. At the same time, it is advisable to check for the absence of voltage in the cable before cutting it, or before working in the junction box or panel. Sometimes this device can find a live wire in a wall, if it is located close to the wall surface. But it is better to use specialized devices for this. There is no switch to turn off magnetic field search. Therefore, the button may be pressed during storage and the batteries will be discharged. Or the device will start beeping where it is not needed. How to turn it off? Or you need to keep the protective film. But I use the following trick. I just turn one battery over. And put the cover back in place. In this case, no current will flow through the circuit and the batteries will not be discharged. If I need to turn on the magnetic field search, I remove the cover and turn the battery back over. So I turn it on and can use it. I turn it over, and in this form I can store this device. As you can see, the device does not turn on. In general, I am pleased that this tool appeared for me. It is especially good for minor household repairs. Repairing cords of household appliances, extension cords. For stripping wires inside household equipment, for stripping wires in a car. For professional electrical installation, I have another more serious stripper. Although for small electrical installation work this stripper can help. Finding the magnetic field will come in handy if you didn't take a multimeter with this function with you. If you have an old multimeter, then you probably do not have this function, and these clamps will not be superfluous. If you have any questions, ask them in the comments. You can ask them to the seller. I left the link in the description. Tell us which automatic stripper you use now, and how much you like it. Also, what do you think about this stripper, and how useful would you find the non-contact voltage search function in it? Share the video with those who would benefit from it. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss new videos. Click like and see you in new and old videos.